Hi everyone, welcome back. We're going to continue Earth Week with another virtual field trip to a website. So I'm going to share my screen here. So the name of this website is called Eek, which is something you would definitely be screaming if you saw a bee or any one of the other insects and different animals that they have on this page. Sorry, I'm not sure why that just started. So I'm going to put this link in the description section so you guys can check it out for yourself. So this is from Wisconsin, which is a far way away from here, but we can learn some very valuable things from it. So this is the Explore page. We can look at different seasons, identify different animals and habitats. There's actually a Happy Earth Day song on there. Let you guys check that out. Oh look, join the frog chorus. Restoration is with, when an area cannot be tampered with, so the ecological processes can continue, which are very important for our environment and for us. Let's go to the Explore page. All right, here's the Explore page. So they have animals, lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my, frogs, turtles, spiders, eek, birds, butterflies, and worms. How fun. So again, with the importance of Earth Day, it's to keep our environments clean so we can take care of the earth, so we can take care of these animals, which ultimately take care of us. So they have them split up by category. We have amphibians, birds, fish, insects, mammals, other invertebrates, and of course reptiles. So you get to click on those and learn a little bit about them. Should I make you guys eat? I think so. Let's go to insects. Oof, they look oof. Oh no. Yikes. Moths are not my friend. I've had one fly in my eye before. Butterflies, love butterflies. Dragonflies, they're okay. I've heard some old myths that are not true, so don't believe them. Caterpillars. So not only did you get to learn about the different insects, you get to learn about how they interact in the environment and how you can even bring them into your own home. Like you can have a butterfly garden at your own home. You learn about bees, because I'm sure every time you step outside on a really warm day, you're going to run into them. Moths normally out at night. And what was the other thing I want to show you guys? Dragonflies, they'll be out soon. Alright, I can't find the other thing I want to show you guys, but... Alright, so those are your insects there. Click on them, explore them. Let's see what's next. Let's go to mammals. Squirrels, you've seen them around. You learn about bats. We don't normally see those around here. Rabbits, we'll see lots of those. You get to learn about some animals that aren't around here. Like again, like I said before, this website is from Wisconsin, so most of these animals are more common there, but we do share some of them. We have raccoons, skunks. I think the gray squirrel is the one we have around here. There are some fox in some of the fields. And of course we see deer. Alright, so again, you can click on them, find out more about them, find out how we can continue to save them as some of them are becoming endangered. I'm just going to go back to the Explore page so we can get to the next category. can learn about plants, the Great Lakes, again up there by Wisconsin, different habitats that these animals and species live in. Identification, so that's basically testing your knowledge. So if you click on different pictures and you get to see if you really know what they are. Oh, look at this alien profile, the moth. Yeah, that does kind of look like an alien. There's so much on here for you guys to take a look at. American toad, white pelican. It looks like this is just everything mixed into one, the explore page here. All right, let's go to the engage part so you guys can find out different ways, again, that you can help the earth. How you can get involved. You can be the change, being healthier in your community, just, you know, taking care of it. Let's see how we can do that. All right, being the change. So 7 steps to shrink your trash. You can reduce it, you can reuse it, and you can recycle your trash. Again, this is what it talks about, recycling bottles and cans, car care. So again, if you can avoid it, don't drive, because driving is not something that's good for the environment. So if you're at, let's say, one store, for example, and the other store is like right there, you don't need to drive over to the separate parking lot. You can walk to that store. Keeping your water clean, so again, not polluting and throwing things down drains, or eventually, you know, the journey through trash, things will eventually end up in the drain that'll make our water dirty. How to compost, basically what this is saying here, so you can have worms inside of your composter. That'll help keep it nice and healthy. Reducing your energy, making sure that if you're not using a light in a certain room, turn it off. Again, composting, something we did in our first video, so check that out, virtual lesson 1. Reusing your trash for the holidays, so it looks like there's some, instead of throwing away your wrapping paper for birthdays, holidays, if it's decent enough, save it so you can reuse it. Saving your water conservation, so saving your water, not having your water running the whole time while you're brushing your teeth, etc. Turn it off. If you like the outdoors as much as I do, now camping is something still, I would think I would need to be in an RV still for, but I would like to go camping one day. So anything you want to do outside, you can find different tips here. And of course, yard care is a big one. When we want to keep our grasses green, but some of those things that we put in our grass is not good for the environment. All right. Different careers. So there's lots of careers if you have an interest in environmental science that you guys can check out and see what you need to do to become, to get into one of those fields. Outdoor safety. Let's go to that, because that's a big one. Make sure you guys get outdoors if you can. Again, just make sure you have social distancing. So here's some different things you can do outside. Once things start to open up more, we have canoeing in the summer, fishing. So again, some of this stuff might be just for Wisconsin, but there's some things we can do around here that are similar. So anytime you're in the sun, you want to make sure you have sunscreen on if you're out there for a long time. Campfire safety tips, so you know fire is not anything to play with. It tells you about ticks, mosquitoes, those little bugs that can get on you. They can cause bumps and rashes, and they can make you itch, and it's not really good for your body. So just try to keep an eye out for that. Make sure you have on bug spray. Talks about how being in direct sun for a long time is not really good for your skin. So it will tell you how long you should be outside in direct sunlight. Next. Again, it has events in Wisconsin, but you can also find events on our local pages. Let's see. So they have some videos about the different animals and plants. Greening our world. So some of your schools might have green teams. Those are your students and staff that are in charge of making sure that you're being as green as possible. Talks about water conservation and recycling. This is how Wisconsin schools are staying green, but I'm sure if you search on YouTube as well, you'll find out how Delaware schools are staying green as well. And then here are some activities. So you guys get on here and do some of these experiments. I'm going to do one myself and I'll post it in the next video. There's some different arts and crafts, experiments, different stories, different books you can read. Reading is so fundamental. Building your own composting box. So again, I've already done one of these activities. I've done planting. So I've already planted and I have my composter here. And then I'm going to do another activity. And if you guys do them, please send them in to us at sandycafe@gmail.com. And we love to put your pictures and include your videos in our lessons. So again, check out this website. I'm going to put the link in the description. It's Earth Week. Show us how you're going to celebrate. Send us your pictures and your videos. We got to take care of our Earth. Even though we can't really be out in it right now, we want to take care of it. We want to make sure that we're taking care of our Earth because we only get one. I also forgot to include, look at the top right, there are games you can play. So go check those out. Happy Earth Week, everyone. See you again soon.
Hey guys, Miss Kristen here. Today we're going to be introducing a guest exercise instructor by the name of Mr. Derek. His activities are made possible through the Delaware Division of Public Health's Tobacco Prevention Community Contract. Funding for this contract is provided by the Delaware Health Fund and managed by the American Lung Association in Delaware. Super excited to see these videos, so you guys stay tuned.
Hey, what's up guys? My name is Derek. I'm going to be your dance instructor again today. Today we're actually going to be learning some old school dances. I know, old school. You guys like to do your own thing, your new school dances, but today we're going to take it back, and I think you guys like it. Some of you may be familiar with some of these dances. You might have seen them on YouTube, you may have seen your parents do them, or you just may be familiar with these dances because, I don't know, you have family members or you just like dancing and you just know all old school, new school stuff. All right, so the first dance that we're actually going to be doing is called the Humpty Dance. The Humpty Dance originated from a rapper named Humpty Hump. I know, a rapper named Humpty Hump. Kind of weird, right? All right, so Humpty Hump was part of a group called Digital Underground from the early 90s, which actually involved the late, great Tupac Shakur before he went on to do his own thing in his solo rap career. All right, so the first steps in doing the Humpty Dance is you actually want to get this bounce going. All right, now once you get this bounce going, you want to get this right arm and left arm backstroke motion. It's kind of like swimming backwards, all right? So you rock, rock, right arm, left arm, right arm, left arm, right arm, left arm. You kind of swing side to side, you naturally do that. When you move your right arm and your left arm, you kind of swing the opposite way. All right, so the next step, which is very important part of the dance, is to add, it's like a quick 1-2 hop, okay? All right, so I can show you what this looks like. I know you're probably thinking, how are we gonna hop and do that arm and bounce motion at the same time? I'm gonna show you what it looks like and then you guys see if you can follow along. All right, so it's right arm, left arm, hop. All right, it's like a 1-2 hop. All right, so it's 1-2, really quick, 1-2. Can you guys do that? 1-2, 1-2. All right, so I'm gonna start from the beginning. We're bouncing. Right arm, left arm, one, two. Right arm, left arm, one, two. All right? Or it may be easier to do the one, two hop. It's one, two, right arm, left arm, 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 right arm, left arm, right arm, left arm, right arm, left arm. You guys got that? All right, you think you're ready to try it with some music? I know it looks kind of weird, but once you put the music on, it'll feel a little bit better. You can kind of bounce to the rhythm. All right, it's kind of hard to dance without a beat, right? All right, so you guys ready to do this with some music? All right, let's give it a go. We're starting with the 1-2 bounce first, and then we're gonna go with our right arm, left arm motion, okay? All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bounce. Bounce, right arm, left arm. Bounce, right arm, left arm. Bounce, right arm, left arm. Hey. How you guys doing out there? All right. Whew, guys, I don't know about you, but I worked up a sweat. So if you worked up a sweat as well and you want to get a drink of water or just take a few minutes to catch your breath, go right along. Then we're going to move on to the next dance, okay? All right, so I'll give you guys a second to do that. And then we're going to move to our next dance. All right, the next dance is called the Harlem Shake. Some of you might be familiar with this dance already. The Harlem Shake originated in the early 2000s in New York City from the borough of Harlem, of course. The dance was first seen on television in a rapper named G. Dep's featuring Puff Daddy's video, okay? All right, so the Harlem Shake, it's a lot of shoulder and hip motion simultaneously, all right? So it's important to follow along. All right, so the first part is the shoulder motion, all right? And the second part is the hip motion. So I'm gonna show you the shoulder motion first, and it's a three count. Remember, dancing is all about timing. So it's 1, 2, 3. So it's right, left, right. 1, 2, 3. And then you go to left, right, left. Okay? So it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay? Now, once you get that shoulder motion, you gotta add the hip part to it the second one. All right, so it's 1, 2, hip thrust. 1, 2, hip thrust. So it's right, left, right, hip thrust, left. Okay? Because it's kind of a natural movement. When you move your shoulders to the right, your hips kind of move a little bit to the left, all right? So it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, so I'm gonna do it in fast motion because the shoulder motion in real time, it's really fast. You can barely see how many times I'm actually moving my shoulders. It's like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that's how the dance looks. It's a really quick shake and then hip thrust. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. All right, you guys got that? All right. So once you get that part, the last part is just adding your own swag to it. You can do all types of just silly stuff. Dancing, especially freestyle dancing, it's all about individuality and having fun. So you can do 1, 2, 3, swing your arms. 1, 2, 3, swing your arms. 1, 2, swing your arms up. You know, instead of doing a hip thrust, you can just throw your arms up. I see people do crazy stuff, you know, in between. It's, you know, it's more for the experienced people that are comfortable with the dance, but you don't have to do that if you don't want. It's just, you know, adds a little fun to it. All right, so you guys think you're ready to do this dance with some music behind it? All right, you guys ready? Remember your count. And 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, hit. 1, 2, 3, hit. 1, 2, 3, hit. 1, 2, 3, hit. Hey! Hey, you don't swag to it now, guys. I'm tired of all that, so that's it for today. Give yourselves a high five. You guys did great. I had a lot of fun with you guys. Until next time, high five.
Hey, Mr. Williams here. Thank you all. Thank you all for your continued support of our online sessions. Till next time.